Hello everyone and welcome back to another walkthrough made by me, Glover Randall, aka Bulbugia, of GameMinima.com and of YouTube. And we're going to be replaying Let's Play Diddy Kong Racing because of the fact that the game itself is 100 times better than emulator, graphical wise, anyway. Diddy Kong Racing. Okay, so first thing that I want to be doing is getting Pipsy. Going through the caution trap, even though it's not really necessary. Raising my veil. Going back through it. Inserting my name again. Just for you guys, and then we're gonna watch the introduction again. So when you're actually in the game, when you're on a genie map, which is this like blue elfin faced thing, you're just gonna beep your horn, and he'll come over to you, and you can change any vehicle that you want or do any races with him that you've already done. But unfortunately I haven't done any races with him yet, so I can't do any of that. So I gotta come up here, grab that balloon, come over here, and there's another balloon in the doorway that I came down. If I could actually do it right, which is a shame because I normally can. I think it may just be me not getting used to the emulator as quickly as I thought I did. Okay, now I basically want to head down here to the beach area for the palm trees, and on my left, past all this water, there's another balloon right by this cliff, as you can see. And for here, we go, four balloons. Oh. And now basically all I want to do is head over to the pathway that he came down, which is actually the first domain of the game. Which is kind of ironic in some ways, but it kind of indicates you to going into the right direction. Oh, maybe it's his purpose in the game after all. But the first level is Ancient Lake, and it costs one balloon to open up, so you gotta have one balloon before you even come in this place anyway. Basically, these races, they consist of 3 labs and 7 other individual characters, this including your own. So you gotta have, over here, basically collect power-up balloons to indicate what sort of power-up you'll get, and unfortunately I didn't get a key that I wanted, but get power-up balloons to either make you go faster, get weapons to hit your other players with, or traps that you can set up for people to run into when they're driving. Or you can get protection and magnets. Magnets pull you forwards closer to the other players, and protection just puts a little shield on you, so any like projectile or any sort of road mine or anything like oil mine or bubble, it can basically be deflected with the shield, and then you will not take any sort of damage at all. Bum ba-dum. Bum 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 ba-dum. Ancient Wake has always been like one of the levels where you just have to play it once every time you turn on this game. Bum ba-da-bum bum bum bum. At least for me it has been. And there we go, we finished in first. I never even noticed that. There's slight transparency behind the first. And that's actually really freaking loud to the point where I have to take off one headphone just to make sure I'm not shouting. Because I probably am. Okay, there we go. So after we get that one balloon, it adds to our total, and best key that we got on that level, it goes to an area in the domain and unlocks a door. That door unlocks a minigame where we get a piece of a TT amulet, which is something we will need towards the end of the game. But enough about that for now, let's just go to Fossil Canyon. Oh, and my cat has woken up, if you can hear that in the background. I think we can, I'm not sure, can't tell by my mixer level. Anyway, Fossil Canyon, second level of the game. I'm not sure why, but I had trouble recording this last time. Like, I did a test, and it just lagged out all of a sudden, as in, like, this level just began to stop lag, like, hesitate. And it's like, why are you doing this? You shouldn't be doing this. This computer's, like, more than powerful to run the emulator at these settings. The highest end emulator settings for 1.7 are pretty demanding, to be honest. It does require quite a lot of processing power, however. This processor should be able to handle it. I mean, it's doing, what, 2.6, 2.8? It's an older quad core. It's an Athlon 2, as it's 50, but it's only doing, like, 2.8 gigahertz a core. Right now, sorry, I was trying to like turn my head to see if somebody won something from my room there. Because it felt like the door opened, but it didn't. So if I hit a brick wall, then that's why. Anyway, and this doesn't seem to have had a problem this time, actually, which is kind of odd in some ways. I'm kind of actually late recording latest in some ways. It's a shame that this emulator is not to the point of perfection where it just can do whatever it wants. If that makes any sense at all, really. I think I'm gonna invest in a hard drive soon, like a good hard drive, not just a standalone, off the wall sort of one. I wanna basically get a faster RPM. Because, I mean, the one that I use right now is 5400, it's not good enough to be doing crash recordings, really. It needs to be 72 in the dark, like, a solid state to really handle anything. This is for me, okay, you can skip that, by the way, all the animation, so you don't have to watch every time. I'm gonna go in here to Jungle Falls and do this level pour. Well, I'm probably gonna do this, and then I'm probably gonna do, Hop-Top Volcano before I wrap up entirely for this video. I don't want to do the Triceratops race until I'm done. Like, with this whole area sort of thing. Like, I don't want to do it in this video because I know it will just overlap to beyond to, like, 11 minute mark. And if you have one of those accounts and wait for the 11 minute, well, past the 11 minute mark like I do, then you'll notice yourself when you're trying to upload a long HD video. It takes forever for it to process in HD. It was beyond the 11 minute mark, mainly because of the fact that it's like rendering two videos for YouTube, anyway. I missed the marker because of the fact that I yawned. This game in general was actually one of my favorite games as a kid. I really enjoyed playing this game. I would sit here for weekends and like weekends, just delete my files, start over again, and sit here and play it over and over and over again. I gotta say though, it's pretty weird not playing with an N64 controller, but hey, I'll live with it. Yeah, it didn't lag that time, thank god. I don't know why it did, but I think it may be the FPS setting, so I had it set to 29.97 rather than 30. I guess only 0.3 of a frame, yeah, but it could make a difference. I really have no idea. Hop-Top Volcano. I gotta say though that this emulator makes everything look phenomenal. And apart from like the pixelation text and all that, but like the rendered polygons, they just look awesome in comparison to the actual N64 polygons that you can see on a HD TV now. I mean, N64 games or anything with composite looks horrible on HD TVs, but this is actually looking really nice on one. Yeah, I'm using my HD TV as a monitor or something, so. There we go, lap 2.
Oh. Anyway, what I'm trying to do here is just build up free balloons again and get an absolute rocket boost off right here for this part. Because it's actually pretty long to come through there without, you know, having a power up. This is like one of my favorite soundtracks of N64 games though. I used to have this on my MP3 player, and I formatted my MP3 player like last year, and now I just don't have it anymore. I really have to re-download that soundtrack. Anyway, that's first place. I'm not sure how long I've been recording for right now. I wish Fraps told me, but I really don't know. I'm just gonna guess that, you know, it's being way over my limit sort of thing. Yeah, I'm just gonna guess that it's been way over my limit. What I'm gonna do in the next video is I'm gonna race with Triceratops, and then I'm probably gonna do a few silver coin challenges, and then make another video after that. So, until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later. Thanks, and goodbye.